Hi, everybody. It's Christina with Adaptive Equipment and Caregiving Corner. I have Becca, our OT, with us today. And then we're here to interview Marti with KitchenWise from St. Louis. Marti's going to take Becca, especially our occupational therapist, on a little tour of her model kitchen that she has back here and show us a few things. Marti, before we get started, will you tell us a little bit about your company?
Sure. It's called KitchenWise of St. Louis, and we provide organizational products for the home, for kitchen, bath, closet, and pantry. They're products that make it easier for people to stay in their home longer.
Excellent. And how can people get a hold of you, Marti, to find out more about your company?
Our website is www.kitchenwise.com/St. Louis.
Very good. All right, Marti, we're excited to get started.
Okay, so my first question that I have is, like, do you guys typically go into somebody's home, or is it like somebody that's building a new home in a community, or what do you guys usually do with that?
It can be either. A lot of it so far has been people that already have their homes, and we upgrade the inside of their cabinets. We have products that work out great for that.
Okay.
Can I show you my favorite one that is great for the baker?
Yes.
Oh, I opened the wrong one. So this is great for a baker. We all know how heavy our KitchenAid mixers are. And wait till you see this.
Oh, that is so cool.
It comes right up.
And you don't even have to really even move it onto the counter because it seems
you
pretty sturdy.
Mix right here on this.
Okay.
And then it comes back down. So yeah, it's great. You can keep all of your accessories for your mixer down underneath.
Okay.
And those can easily be pulled out too.
Oh, very cool. Now, one question I have is about the height of the counter. So typically with like aging in place, sometimes residents or patients will be in a wheelchair, and so they don't do a ton of standing in the kitchen. That is a great spot for them to stand. Is there a way to have a lower cabinet or countertop, or is that something?
As I said, we usually just work with the inside of the cabinets. We don't, get products. I'm not sure if we can get them lower or shorter, but we may be able to get shorter products.
Okay, cool. Very good. I love just how the drawers just easily just pull out.
Yes. And so does this one.
Mm-hmm.
This is a spice cabinet. This is for all your spices.
Mm-hmm.
It makes it very easy to get to, so you don't have to try to reach in the back and get the ones that are in those hard places.
Mm-hmm.
And they all have the soft close.
And I like the handles too, so they're not like the small little ones. You can kind of just, because for some of the patients and people that we work with, grip is not always the best. So having that easy, they can slide that hand in there and be able to pull it out. I'm going to pull some of these.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so this is a double utility.
Okay.
And your flatware in here. And this is an organizational tool that makes it easier for everybody to be able to find their stuff, their knives, their utensils and everything
like that. Oh, I love it.
And this, I don't know if I can get it up with this is a great place to keep a crock pot or something else. It makes it easier. This one doesn't lift out, but you could also keep the crock pot on this appliance lift.
Absolutely. I love that. So do you have any stories of people that you have worked with recently that have really been huge for them too, because a lot of patients that we work with, I've done home health and then working into nursing home or assisted living.
Yeah.
And some of these things, the smallest thing, can be that deciding factor on where they stay at home.
Yes.
As opposed to having to go somewhere. Have you had any experiences, any stories like that with any clients?
Yes.
Recently?
About 2 months ago, we worked with a client. They lived in a big, beautiful home, but it was really too much for them. They couldn't get to the back of their cabinets. And they had us come in and we modified some of their cabinets and were able to put in some products to make it easier for them to, they didn't have any kids or grandchildren close by to dig to the back of the cabinets.
Yep.
So we were able to provide some things so that they don't ever have to worry about that again.
Yes.
They're all on these rollers and pullouts and they're able to, especially this, they love this. They got a lot of these.
Mm-hmm.
That are products.
Those drawers.
Yeah, it's just organizational, but you don't ever have to worry about digging to the back of your cabinets again.
And just having all of that stuff close too, that would be something that an OT would come in and, work with the patient on.
Right.
Hey, what do you typically eat? What kind of tools or gadgets do you typically use? Those are the things that we put at the top drawers
or,
knowing that we have that ability to be able to pull that drawer out and have that easy access.
And I've heard a lot of people that need help, they keep things on top of their counter.
Yes.
And it, you know, if you're an organized person, that would drive me crazy.
Yes.
But hopefully some of these products would make it easier for them to still be able to keep products and drawers and our pullouts and everywhere.
Well, and they're just beautiful, too.
Yeah, they are.
It's appreciation of the interior design. Yeah.
So the couple I was talking about, they were able to put everything inside and still be able to reach it. And she was a baker.
Yeah.
And she was able to bake on top of this, and or mix on top of this, mm-hmm. and it really saved her.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
I love it. Just those simple things. Like, that is very similar to what we do as therapists and OTs. You know, finding those simple ways to make somebody more independent and more functional without having to rely on grandchildren or caregivers or somebody else. So I love that. Yeah. That's great.
I love this drawer, this diagonal drawer. This has been very popular
so cool.
Keep all your tools in, barbecue tools or anything larger that you
for those
have.
Longer spoons, stirring spoons, all that stuff.
So, Becca, what do you think? That's pretty cool, isn't it?
Super cool. Yeah, I like it. So, you know, we talked about like the perfect prime candidate, a patient or a person to work with on this. Yeah. We have so much stuff. Everybody's got the Tupperware container or cabinet, right?
Sure.
All of the things. And so we have clients that are bending down, have a bad back, you know, bad hips, bad knees. Mm-hmm. And so having to be in that uncomfortable position while you dig is just asking for an injury, a fall or something like that. And so being able to have that accessibility to pull the things out a little bit closer to you or pop up, elevate up closer to you is just excellent for that aging in place, that independence for all of the patients that we're trying to get.
Exactly. You know, and I feel like with occupational therapy, usually your biggest answer is put it on the cabinet, right? Put it on the cabinet. And for some people, that's clutter, and they're not comfortable with clutter. Yeah. So this is kind of the answer to decluttering and still having access to that.
Yes. And, you know, and I don't get me wrong, aesthetics and that stuff should not be materialistic something. But, you know, if you're going to be living at home and it's something that's important to you, I think it should be important to you, and you should get what exactly it is to be able to keep you at home as long as possible and making you independent. So.
Yeah, and then there's a dignity factor to it, I think, too. If that's your thing.
And, you know, you have family come over or whatever. Because I remember my grandma, she would just have all of her stuff on the countertop and she would just dig around that, you know, find whatever you need to get here. And so it's, which is fine again, but that dignity factor, that pride, you know, it's nice to have. Your kitchen. Like, that's a spot that a lot of my patients, usually female patients, are very prideful about.
That's right.
They want to have a nice, clean kitchen whenever they cook or make whatever it is that they're making. That's their spot. That's their home. So.
Excellent. So what would you say of all the things, what was your favorite piece?
I love that mixer. I love the mixer, how it just like pops up and that you don't even have to get, those things are heavy.
They're
super heavy. And so I have a problem having to pick it up from the lower part. So I wouldn't even have my patient fiddle with that. I would have them put it on the counter. Being able to have this pop up and just keep it right there, plug it into the wall and make whatever it is, have your prep work and all that stuff to toss in. So I think that's probably, I like the long spoons. So again, you don't have to put them on the countertop and stack them in your big canister. I want that. but yeah, I think those are my favorite things.
Great.
Yeah. Absolutely.
All right. Very good. Well, thanks for helping us, Becca. I really appreciate it.
Of course.